Hey everyone, welcome to our guide on how to add a contact to a specific point in an automation. My name's Tim, and today I'll be walking through the process of how to add a contact to a specific point in an automation using a goal action. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a tag, create a goal action, and then manually add that contact to the automation. Let's get started. Firstly, what we'll need to do is create a tag. To do this, we want to click Contacts on the left-hand side of the screen. When we're in Contacts, we want to then select Tags. This will take us through to the Manage Tag section. In the upper right corner, we are going to click Add a Tag. The tag I'm going to use today is Contact Skip. So I'm going to type that in, and once we're finished, we then click Save. Now it's time to add that goal to your automation. Firstly, go to your automation and locate the action you want the contact to jump to. I'm going to pop them in just before the follow-up email. What I'm going to do is click the plus sign above the step, which is right here. Add new action will be displayed. We want to select conditions and workflow. Then I want to select goal. Now I'm going to show you how to configure this goal so we can manually add a contact to this automation and they will go directly to this action. First, we need to name the goal. Let's keep it simple. I'm just going to type in skip to email. Now you'll need to create a condition that the contact must meet in order to go directly to this goal. You really can use any condition you like, but I prefer using a tag, so that's the one we created earlier. So to create this condition, firstly, we just need to select the first box and then type in tag. It will automatically default to exists, which is exactly where we wanted to be, so we won't touch that. Then in the third box, we're going to type the name of the tag. In our circumstance, it is going to be contact skip. The next configuration will leave exactly as it is. It'll actually be as when the goal is in below contact's position, option selected. What this means is the goal must be below the contact's position in the automation in order for the contact to jump to it. Since we will be triggering any conversions when the goal is achieved, we can just keep that option as none. As for the last step, we just need to configure continue anyway option. This means that when contacts who don't have the tag referenced, they won't go through the goal as go through like it doesn't exist. The goal is now in your automation. Congratulations. Now we'll need to add the contact to the automation. Firstly, we'll need to add the tag to the contact you created. Then we need to then add them to the automation manually. To do this, firstly, we need to locate the contact you wish to add the automation to. Now, scroll down to the middle section and you will see tags. We want to actually type the name of the tag we created into that tag field, which is contact skip. And once we've actually done that, we've now applied it to the contact. Next, we want to manually add the contact to the automation. To do so, click the Add button located in the automation row, which is right here. Then check the checkbox to next to the automation you want to add the contact to, and then click OK. The contact will now be added to your automation and you have met your goal. If you want to make sure this works and there's been no problems, click the automation, then click the View button. You'll be able to see exactly where this has actually gone. And you'll see that it's gone to the next step. Wow, that was a lot. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this. Hope to see you all in the next one.
Subscribe to our channel below for more content like this. And to try ActiveCampaign free for 14 days, visit ActiveCampaign.com.